Welcome students. Today we are going to discuss the process of beta decay. Why does beta decay happen? Beta decay happens when the parent nucleus wants to attain the stability. They are not stable, so they emit from itself beta particle. The beta decay could be a electron emission, a positron emission, or it could be sometimes electron capture. So it decays by emitting electron, positron, or capturing an electron to become stable daughter nucleus. So in beta decay process, we have three types of decays, which are electron emission. Electron emission is also called as the beta minus decay or electron decay. Second is positron emission, that is beta plus decay. And third is the electron capture. As we all know that the nucleus consists of protons and neutrons, and both the protons and neutrons are surrounded by the meson clouds. So these meson clouds are interacting in such a way that we say that protons and neutrons are just changing its state. That is why we had regarded that the proton and neutron are a mass entity which are differing from each other by the meson cloud, where the meson cloud could be a positive meson, that is pi plus meson cloud, a negative cloud of mesons, that is pi minus meson cloud, and a neutral meson cloud. So these meson clouds are favoring the attraction or interaction between two protons, two neutrons, one proton, one neutron. So these were the Yukawa forces which were responsible for holding the protons and neutrons inside the nucleus. So due to it, there is electron emission, positron emission, or electron capture. In the beta decay, beta minus decay process, it is not that the electron is present inside the nucleus. It is that the constituents, that is the protons or neutrons, are changing into one another. And when they are decaying into each other, then the electron or positrons are created, which are ejected out of the nucleus. So what happened? That the neutron changed into proton and the electron was also released out. So initially it was proposed that only neutron would be changing into proton and electron. But accounting for the conservation of energy and momentum, Pauli proposed that instead that the neutron disintegrates into a proton and electron, it also emits another elementary particle which is called as the antineutrino. So these neutrinos are also possible in two states, that is neutrino and antineutrino. So the neutron decays into a proton, electron, and an antineutrino. So when this happens, then we say that the beta minus decay or the electron emission is taking place. So electron is not residing inside the nucleus, but the neutron is changing into proton, which is resulting in the emission of electron from the nucleus. So when the electron emission takes place or beta minus decay takes place, so how is the change in the nucleus of the parent atom taking place? So here if we consider the parent nuclei as ZXA, so ZXA, after releasing an electron and an antineutrino particle, here the number of protons of the daughter nucleus would be increased. So what happens, that the Z is converted into Z plus 1 and the mass number remains the same because the neutrons are remaining the same. So neutron has converted into proton, so A remains the same, but the Z has increased by Z to Z plus 1. Here minus 1, so because we know that for every radioactive equation, the atomic number and the mass number has to be balanced. So here on the left hand side, we have the atomic number equal to Z, and on the right hand side, we have the atomic number as Z plus 1 and minus 1, where the sum of both gives us a total of Z, and the mass numbers are A on both the sides. So the conservation of the atomic number and the mass number is holding here in this equation. So if we suppose that Mi is the mass of the parent nuclei and Mf is the mass of the daughter nuclei, that is the final product. So we have written Mf, and Me is the mass of the electron. So according to the law of conservation of energy, we have to take into account the energies on the left hand side and the right hand side, and both the sum of the energies on the left hand side should be equal to the sum of energies on the left hand side or right hand side. So here what we are having, that this nucleide is having a rest mass energy of mi c square, where since it was at rest position, so the kinetic energy of the parent nucleide is taken to be zero, that is ti is zero here. For the daughter nuclei, we have the rest mass energy as mf c square and the kinetic energy as tf. For the electron, we have taken the rest mass energy as me c square and the kinetic energy as te. Since we are here talking about the energy term, so we have to evaluate this energy in terms of Q, where Q value is given by the difference in the energies of the kinetic energies on the right hand side minus the energies on the left hand side, that is the energies of the product minus the energy of reactants. So on the product side, we have the daughter nucleus and the electron, and on the left hand side we have the parent nucleus. So Q is the difference of the kinetic energy of the product and the reactants. So we get TF plus TE minus of TI, that is the kinetic energy of the parent nuclei. But since the kinetic energy of the parent is zero, so therefore that Q will be equal to TF plus T, that is the kinetic energy of the daughter and the kinetic energy of the electron. So from this equation we can say that TF plus TE will be equal to what, taking the rest mass energies to the left hand sides. So we get that TF plus TE will be mi c square minus mf c square minus me c square. So it will be, taking c square common, we get mi minus mf minus me. So what is Q value given? Where the Q value was the difference in the sum of the kinetic energies of the product minus reactants. Whereas in this case, in the case of rest mass energies, the Q value is given by the difference of the rest mass energy of the reactant and then the product is being subtracted. So mi minus mf minus me. So this is initial minus final, whereas for the kinetic energy it was final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. As we know, for any reaction to take place, the Q value, that the energy should be greater than zero. So for this, if this Q is greater than zero, what we say, if this is greater than zero, then C square goes on left, right hand side and equates to be zero. So we get mi should be greater than mf plus me. That is, the mass of the initial parent atom should be greater than the mass of the daughter nucleus and the electron mass. Then only this reaction, this beta minus decay will take place. So for beta minus decay, that is, the Q value should be greater than zero and the mass of the parent atom, parent nuclei, should be greater than the mass of the daughter nuclei and the electron. So if we consider the atomic masses, so let us see what is the mass of the parent. In terms of masses, we get that mza minus m of, since this daughter is having a total charge of z plus 1, so we write for the daughter nucleus, it is mz plus 1 a minus me. So we are, instead of taking the rest masses, we are taking the total mass of the nucleus. So for initial, for the parent we have mza, for the daughter we have the mass of mz plus 1 a, and this is the mass of the electron, we have taken it to be me. Now what we do in this equation, we just simply add and subtract the z mass of electrons. Okay, so we are adding z me's and subtracting z me's, which makes no difference to this equation. So now collecting the terms, so we have retained z me with this term, and we had summed up this z me and me, so this will account to be z plus 1 me. So taking negative common, we get mz plus 1 a plus z plus 1 me. So this was the mass of the nucleus. Mza was the mass of the nucleus. But since this is having z protons, it will have z electrons also. So when we take into account the mass of the z electrons as well as the mass of the nucleus, then this total whole will be accounting the mass of the atom of a particular element, whichever element is disintegrating as beta decay or not. So your mza and zme in terms of atomic energy, atomic masses, will be given as let it be equal to mza, where this mza was the mass of the nucleus, where we can write like this also, that this is m dash za, where m dash za is the atomic mass of the parent atom. And similarly, this mz plus 1a, when is added with z plus 1 times the mass of electrons, means this daughter nucleus is having z plus 1 electrons in the outermost shells. So this whole entity will be now the mass of the atom of the daughter nucleus. So it is the atomic mass of the daughter. So this term, in terms of atomic masses, this whole term can be written as m dash za, and this term can be written as m double dash z plus 1a. So we know that for beta minus decay, again Q should be greater than 0. So if this value is greater than 0, what does this mean? That the mza should be greater than mz plus 1a. Means for beta minus decay or for electron emission, the mass of the parent should be greater than the mass of the daughter nucleus. So if this case is there, where the parent atom is having more mass as compared to the daughter nucleus, then the electron emission is feasible, otherwise it will not be feasible. So this is the condition we have got in the electron emission, that the mass, atomic mass of the parent atom should be greater than the atomic mass of the daughter element for electron emission to take place. So this was the first process of beta decay, that was the electron emission or beta minus decay. So next, let's come to the second type of beta decay, that is the positron emission or beta plus decay. So as we have discussed in electron emission, where the neutron converted into a proton and electron and antineutrino was released. So here in the positron emission, what happens, that the proton is changing into a neutron. Okay, so proton is changing into neutron and a positron is emitted and a neutrino is also emitted. So neutrino was also emitted to conserve the law of energy and momentum. So in the positron emission, proton changes into a neutron, a positron and a neutrino. So if we consider the reaction decay process in terms of the parent atom and the parent nuclei and the daughter nuclei, so there would be the change, that the nuclei ZXA would be changing to Z minus 1, because for positron it is plus 1. So to account for the conservation of the atomic number, so Z should be Z minus 1 and plus 1. So Z minus 1 plus 1 is again Z, and the mass numbers remain same, that is A on both the sides. So the conservation of atomic number and mass numbers are holding here. So the decay process is here taking place as ZXA is changing to Z minus 1 YA and positron and a neutrino. So again, let us see how the Q values of the reaction are involved here. So the Q value is given by the difference of the mass of the parent atom and the masses of the daughter nucleus and the positron. So Q is Mi minus Mf minus Me positive. Whereas in the case of kinetic energy, it would be the Q value will be equal to Tf plus Te minus the parent. But the parent has at rest, so kinetic energy will be 0. So Q will be Tf plus Te. And the Q will be given in the terms of rest mass energies as Mi minus Mf, where Mf is the daughter nucleus and Me positive is the positron mass, where positron and electrons have nearly same masses. So this is Mi minus Mf minus Me positive C square. So if we write this equation in terms of the mass of the nucleus, so Mi would be written as Mza and Mf would be written as M having Z minus 1 protons and A nucleons. And this is Me C square. So again, what we do, again we subtract and add Zme, that is the ZME positives. So what we give here, that is MZA minus ZME plus ZME minus MZ minus 1A. Here it was a minus sign, so minus plus minus ME positive. So since it is electron and positron are having the similar masses, so we are writing as ME itself. So MZA plus ZME, we have included this ZME with this mass ZA, that is the parent atom. and taking this ZME to the other side with the daughter nucleus. So this ZME can be written as Z minus 1 plus 1. Since we want only Z minus 1 electrons or Z minus 1 positrons associated with the daughter nucleus, so we take Z minus 1 MEs. So here 1 ME would be left out, there is a negative sign, so it would be minus ME, and here it is also minus ME. So this minus ME and minus ME accounts for 2 MEs. So what we get here, we get MZA plus ZME minus MZ minus 1A minus of Z minus 1 ME minus 2 MEs. So we get then this whole entity would be what? This will be the mass of the atom of the parent nucleus. So the parent element will have a mass of total atom, mass of the atom will be given by MZA. And this here, this quantity and this quantity will account for the total mass of the atom of the daughter element. So this will be MZ minus 1 into A, where we have left out with the 2 times the electronic mass or the 2 times the positron mass. So we know that for the beta positive reaction also to take place, the Q value should be greater than 0. So if Q is greater than 0, then this equation should be greater than 0. When this equation is greater than 0, what we can say? We can say that this MZA should be greater than MZ minus 1A plus 2ME. So that is why we have written here that MZA is greater than MZ minus 1A plus 2ME positive. Means that the parent atom in the case of positron emission, in case of positron emission, the mass of the atom, atomic mass of the parent should be greater than the atomic mass of the daughter nucleus, as well as it should be greater by what factor? It should be greater by a factor of 2 times the electronic mass or 2 times the positronic mass. So MZA is greater than what must be the mass of the parent atom? The mass of the parent atom should be such that it is equal to the mass of the daughter nucleus plus twice the mass of the electron mass or twice the mass of the positron. So this condition, if this condition is holding good, then only the positron emission or beta plus decay will take place. Whereas if the mass of the atomic mass of the parent is greater than only the mass of the daughter nucleus, and it is not greater that it is greater than 2 MEs or less than, then positron emission will not take place, then only beta minus decay will take place. So this is the factors that are responsible for beta minus decay or beta plus decay. So now let's, on the similar lines, we come to the third type of the beta emission, that is the electron capture. So in electron capture, this electron capture is similar to the positron emission. So what happens here, that a proton is capturing an electron and it is changing into a neutron and a neutrino. If we take this electron to the other side, what it would be? It would be just electron is changing into a positron to balance the equation. So here what is happening, that in the electron capture, a proton is capturing an electron and changing into neutron and a neutrino. So if we want to write the decay process, so what will be the decay process here, that the parent atom ZXA captures an electron minus 1 electron 0 and it forms a daughter nucleus which is having Z minus 1 protons and having A nucleons. So here also we can see this ZXA and ZN minus 1 YA are also regarded as isobars, because in isobars the number of nucleons remains the same. So these are having same number of nucleons. So these are isobars. So in these case, electron emission, positron emission and the electron capture, we are able to form the isobars. So ZXA plus electron reacts to form Z minus 1 YA and a neutrino. So this is the decay equation of the electron capture. So on the similar lines, as we calculated for the electron emission and the positron emission, we now calculate for the Q value for the electron capture. So Q value will be again given by the same, that is the Q value of the mass of the, that is the mass of the reactants minus the mass of the product. So on the reactant side, now we have the mass of the parent and the mass of electron. So here we have Mi plus Me, and on the reactant side we have only the daughter nucleus, so that is why only one term is being subtracted, that is MF. So we get that Q is equal to Mi plus Me minus MF into C square. So here the Q value will be given in terms of radius, in terms of the nuclear masses, we can say that this is equal to MZA, and this for electron we have Me, and for this product side, that is the daughter nucleus, we have M of Z minus 1A. So again, what we do, again we subtract this ZME and add ZME on both to this Q value equation. So again, this in terms of atomic energy, if we want, that this total will give us the value of MZA, that is the mass of the atom of the parent nuclei, parent element. So here we have MZ minus 1, this ME and this minus ZME would account to be total of Z minus 1 ME. So again this, so this is the atomic mass of the parent, and this will be atomic mass of the daughter element. So for this term we can write as MZA, and here is a negative sign. So here we can write that this is M of Z minus 1 A, that is the atomic mass of the daughter. So for electron capture, as in the case of beta plus, beta minus, for electron capture also the Q value should be greater than 0. So in terms of atomic masses, we can write MZA minus MZ minus 1A C square should be greater than 0, or MZA should be greater than MZ minus 1A. So here also the parent atom should, mass of the parent atom should be greater than the mass of the daughter atom. But in the case of electron emission, the mass of the parent atom MZA was greater than the daughter atom, where the daughter had Z plus 1 protons. Where in the case of electron capture, the mass of the parent atom is greater than the mass of daughter, where the daughter is having Z minus 1 proton. So this is the basic difference where electron capture and the beta emission, beta minus emission is taking place. And for beta positive emission, the mass of the parent should be such greater that it is greater than MZ minus 1A by an additional factor of 2 times the mass of the electron or mass of the positron. So these are the various conditions which accounts for the various beta decays, whether which type of beta decay process will take place, either it will be beta minus, beta plus and beta plus, or electron capture. So we have to remember these conversions of neutron and protons into its constituents, that how they are changing, and we have to remember these decay process. So on these decay lines we can calculate the Q values of the energy. So I hope that you must have understood the concept of beta decay, and in the next module we shall try to understand the beta spectra. So thank you.